Onivia, League of Legends highlights, powered by ArcaneBet.com. Bet live on esports.
Risky here, but at least you have the all-in potential. If you stack a few poison clouds on a target that gets snared, you can't stand and fight against that as easily on the side.
We'll see either the invade into the jungle or the path down to the bottom lane. So Trick knows Brox is on the way and we'll spot him again.
Brox is in so much trouble. Gonna have to flash over the wall. Makes it. Here comes Sven. First blood for Sven. And he gets doubles.
And this is a problem now when your play style.
Doesn't have any defensive steroids at level 6, right? She just gets a little bit stronger at what she already does. And that makes her a little weak. Now Caps gets poked out.
Yeah, Caps took a lot of damage. Remember earlier, he used that ultimate just to clear the wave. Perks with an insta-cleanse, running for his life. Caps is going low. Exhaust on the Trick, under the tower.
Sven
goes down!
The exhaust from Caps just saved the day.
Is he stealthing?
This is big, though. Four members bot lane.
For the root, not gonna find anything. Stranglethorns is available for Jesus. Look at the damage from the spray and pray. Miffy goes down. Double kill Fnatic.
G2 Esports had everything under control. Now, this is what we all want to see. Trick into this mid lane. Because, again, the bot lane can't really roam. Only Jesus is here. You can see Reckless is moving. They're fighting.
Yeah, teleporting from behind. Brox has already got damage onto Miffy. He gets taken out by the ultimate from Soaz. Perks flashes away from Cap.
By Soaz. And it shows you, if you want to beat Fnatic in this style, you need expect to teleport.
Oh, Sven. Caught by the cocoon. Look at the damage. He's down.
Broxa just hit two extremely important cocoons here.
Sol used to playing conventional League of Legends. Like, why is this so well in Sol here all of a sudden? Sven is probably thinking, with the GLP, he's not used to playing against this, and Caps may get a kill.
And he does. Caps made that look easy.
Remember when we said that Fnatic's comp is not about, like, this pure split push style. It's about being mobile. It's about constantly showing up in lanes.
Oh, look at this! Perks is shut down. Miffy follows. Fnatic are looking at tower number 4. Hell, they might even get more.
It's honestly beautiful. Exactly like this. And they are still crumbling.
All Fnatic needed to do was take the leash off. Go full animal style.
But they're constantly switching things up.
All right, Perks is gonna get away with the cleanse. Trick is knocked back by Soaz. The tower seems to be the focus for Reckless. Perks is down, a voice of light sends him packing. True Shot Barrage tags Soaz and Caps on the way out as Fnatic knock over.
The whole animal style that Finley himself said, by the way, is so unfortunate of a name. Hang on, Sven.
All right, gonna trade damage. Reckless losing out on this one. Blade of the Rune King comes down, spray and pray. Sven is gone, Reckless wins the fight. Redemption heals up Fnatic's remaining members, and Caps is roaming from
being in synergy with each other, because if one guy missteps and goes for an aggressive pickoff and you're not there to help him, he just dies.
Well, Fnatic gonna look for the engage. Look at Trick. He's bounced all the way backwards. He gets dropped as Broxa rappels into the air, buying as much time as possible. Flashes out to safety. The inhibitor tower falls. G2's base is broken open. Soaz still holding onto that GA, and he's gonna have the support of Caps. Voice of Light yells, "You are dead." Inhibitor goes down. Expect gets eaten by a body slam. Fnatic on the
health based on damage taken and given. It's super annoying to play against Aurelion Sol.
Well, they're gonna try and kill him.
Aurelion Sol is locked inside the ultimatum. Trick and Miffy are getting hammered on from the back line, though. Sven keeps throwing out those mystic shots, and Fnatic, they get engaged on.
That is just simply not playing super standard. Like, they went for a group siege in the mid lane. They weren't surprised for Fnatic to push back. Now Trick's getting caught out.
He is indeed. Spray and Pray should send him back in. Shockwave onto Reckless takes a lot of damage. He's gonna potentially catch Perks. Just runs out of ultimate. Caps doesn't have that Voice of Light, I believe. And decides to hold on.
Kill participation. I think Sven is definitely pulling ahead here. 100%.
Thanks for taking my line. I'll go with that one. And first blood as well.
They went with this. First pick, Camille.
Mithy's in the pit, by the way. I don't know how he got there.
Huh. Why is he in there?
Oh, they got the dragon at least.
Did he get Blastcone in? Yes, he must have.
I guess someone would try to run away with the Blastcone. It just keeps showing us that it is so legit and they're playing it so well because it's so fun to watch a team playing this fast paced. And they go for another one.
Oh, they are indeed. Trick almost gets caught by the Stranglethorns. Look at the Celestial Expansion. A lot of damage going onto G2's members. Spray and Pray. Reckless gets a double kill. Make that a triple kill. Perks, the last man standing under the fountain. Fnatic get the Nexus turret and the Nexus. Fnatic fire first in Europe's first semi-final. The crowd chanting Fnatic after a flawless mid-game. As soon as Broxa unlocked some of those plays, that snowball drowned G2's hopes.
The correct play from G2, but it backfired due to Elise landing Cocoon mid lane, Cocoon bot lane. That was kills, towers. The map was wide open, and then Caps took over.
I think there isn't a better way to start the series than this game. Because Fnatic, they still rely on some key picks and some key moments in the game to break it open. So let's not forget, there were two turrets that were virtually knocked over, which would propel G2 forward into an open map.